Hi, today I'd like to demonstrate how you can easily test external webhooks within your Visual Studio web application, all while running your project on localhost. By using the Conveyor Visual Studio extension, we can get a public URL that tunnels direct to our web project. So here we're going to be using Zapier simply as an example. You can, of course, use this as a guide for all other webhooks you might be using. Zapier is a fantastic service that links together a large number of applications and communicates between them. Zapier also provides a webhooks app which, amongst other things, allows you to post to a specific URL that you specify when an event occurs. For our example, we're going to be setting up a Zap which notifies us when a new email arrives to our Gmail account that contains the subject support ticket. So I should mention that you can use these same instructions when setting up any other integration with Zapier. It's not limited to Gmail. Okay, so first things first, we need to set up an empty web application with Web API in Visual Studio, which we will use for receiving our webhooks from Zapier. We don't need to select Azure since we'll be showing you how to open up IIS Express directly over the internet. So now we've created our project, you will need to install the following NuGet package. Then add the following line to the web API config.register method. Our webhook URI for Zapier is going to look like this. The code parameter will need to match the secret key, which we will set in our application like this. The code parameter will need to be between 32 and 128 characters and with a high entropy level. Please see the various online tools if you need help generating this. Now we need to add the file generic.json.webhook.handler.cs to the project. This is going to hold the following class, which will handle our Zapier webhook. Great, so next we need to set up our Zap. As explained before, we'll just be setting up a simple example using Gmail, but you can use these same steps no matter what app you are integrating with Zapier. The webhooks can be set up in the same manner. So start by going to your dashboard and select Make a New Zap. Search for Gmail and set it as the trigger app. Set the trigger as new email matching search. For this tutorial, I have connected my own Gmail account. So when we receive a new email where the subject includes the matching term, in this case support ticket, our trigger is fired. Next, we need to set up the Zapier webhooks post. Choose Webhooks by Zapier as the action app, and then Post as the action. As we will be tunneling to our IIS Express hosted application directly, we need to find the public URL for our project. This is going to be provided by the Conveyor Visual Studio extension. If you haven't already installed the Conveyor extension, you can find this in the Visual Studio Extensions Marketplace under the Tools menu. So now we're going to use Conveyor to obtain a public URL direct to our application. So go ahead and run your web application. The Conveyor window will appear and just click on the Access over Internet button. And if you need to register, then go ahead and register and then log in. Once logged in, the internet URL will be shown within the Conveyor window. Now we're going to set the webhook URL field in Zapier to our URI with your Conveyor internet URL as the host name. So our complete URL is going to look like this. Now set the payload type to JSON. We're just going to finalize things. Now, before you test your new Zap, you will need to make sure, of course, your Visual Studio application, as well as Conveyor, are running. When logged into the Conveyor cloud service, you will see the internet URL displayed in the Conveyor window. If this ever changes, you will, of course, need to just update your webhooks Zapier action accordingly with the updated URL. If we add a breakpoint to our code, we can then see the webhook in action. To trigger our Zap, send an email to Gmail with the subject line support ticket. To speed things up, you can always manually run your Zap. Otherwise, you have to wait for the next time Zapier runs automatically. So we can see that our breakpoint has been hit and Zapier has sent over data via the webhook to our application. So that's it. We've successfully received our Zapier webhook directly to our web application, all while it's running on our local host. Well, I hope you found this video useful, and thank you very much for watching.